exercise we'll do really slow, we'll say foot, body, head. Now, okay. In the past, we've said foot, head. And sometimes we say, well, you can't think about the body. It's going to happen anyway when you move the head. But if you go really slow, you can feel that rhythm of the tango, ba-da-dum, 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 which is the movement of the foot, the movement of the body, and the flick of the head. So we're going to go very slow, and we'll do the rock turn, then we'll do it on the corte at the end. So when you go into your rock turn, let's think of placing the foot, the body, just a little bit of movement of the weight, and then the head. Keep that position under your rock. Foot moves into position. The body rotates under the head, and the head turns to the left. Then do your close. We'll try to separate it out into those three movements. Foot, body, head. Quick, quick. Foot, body, head. Now, while we're doing the body part, you're going to move your weight into that foot and rotate quickly the hips and shoulders and stop. I'm rotating my hips a little less than my shoulders. Our problem here is usually when you do that part, both your hips go forward. So try to put your butt against the wall like you're sitting in a straight back chair. And look in the mirror, because this probably feels natural. So there's my foot, body, head. Try not to move anything but the head. Quick, quick, foot. Now I'm going to turn and sit and turn the head. If we do the same thing on the natural promenade turn, slow, quick, quick. See the head to the left, foot, body, head, and coming out, foot, body, head. So just practice that on those three figures to try to get that separation for the speed, and also so we don't have so much body flying around.
Okay.